Hello everybody, welcome to this video. You guys can make for everybody to do. We're gonna be here learning a brand new aircraft. It's gonna be the FlyJason 727. It's gonna be the V3. And I have never flown this plane before, and I've never really watched any videos of it. I just recently got this aircraft. It's gonna be my first time actually flying it. I never went through the entire system, so I'm completely new to aircraft as a whole. So I'm gonna jump on in, and we're gonna get into it and see how good we can do. We're gonna be flying from LAX to go from LAX to Phoenix. That's what we'll do. Now we're gonna use the SIVA. We're gonna try the SIVA as well. We do have FMC option, but I'll try the SIVA. So I have a manual pulled up on my second monitor, so I'm gonna be reading through that. So sorry if I don't read the chat. All right. So, wait, I don't think this is the right one. Okay, so this doesn't really, it doesn't really help us, so I'm gonna get the, procedures. Cockpit flows, there we go. Alright, so before start checklist, bag preparation procedures, anti-skid. It is usually up here. I don't know where the anti-skid is, but we should be fine. Yeah, we should be fine. Be good. Stall warning, I'm warned by the emergency lights. Be armed. Battery now. Pop this checklist here. Alright, so battery. Long view. Battery is on. Oh yeah, I gotta turn my sound on. Alright, so the battery is on. AP or ground power. Oh, here we go. Battery switches on, battery checked, DC meter selector. Where's a DC meter? AC generator. DC meter. We're gonna set that to battery. There we go. DC meters are checked. Observe DC meter for negative indication. DC volts reads at least 22. Yep. We're good on those. Standby electrical system. Good. Central power selector. On standby. There we go. Do not leave the switch in this position for more than 2 minutes without equipment cooling. DC meters, good. instrument warning, I can worry about that. Essential power selector. Any engine generator. But wait, that's what we just do. External slash APU electrical power reestablished. Okay. Probably actually get our ground power connected. God, that is loud. Okay. All right, so APU fire warning system. On my car, so that's APU. APU fire warning test and switch. APU fire warning test and APU if required start. DC meter selector. Where is the AC? Wait, that's a AC meter selector. So the AC. Oh, here it is, AC meter selector. APU field switch, what's APU master switch? Hold that down for about 3 seconds. APU is coming alive. Observe APU crank light illuminate. DC ammeter read full scale negative. EGT to normal initial rise. After a short delay, observe the APU crank light extinguished, followed by the DC ammeter return to a normal indication. We're gonna go and shut off the ground power. I think we can. AC meters. Observe the frequency stabilize. Okay. 400 plus? Oh, okay, yep. Okay, so 400 and plus, that's good. Plus or negative? Plus or negative. And Volt is stabilized at 115. So that's good. Okay, so AP if desired on, close AP generator, breaker switch. They're not closing though. Understanding. Close AP generator breaker. Okay, there we go. But I still can't close these generators. That's what I'm confused about. Let's see. Generator breaker switch and observe the generator breaker light. Extinguish, observe the voltage frequency at normal. Position the essential power selector to AP. Okay, so that's good. Essential power and observe the essential power failure. And master warn lights extinguished, so it's good. Observe APU ammeter within limits, so it's good, but I still can't close the. Whatever. External power if desired, on, not simulated. Observe the AC connected light illuminated and bus lights are extinguished. No, it's not. Wait. AC connected light. Illuminated and the bus lights are extinguished. Okay, so that's good. Position the external power selector to external power. Okay. That's good. Pressurization system. Let me go and get set up here. You on sim brief here real quick. so we're good there. That's weird. Alright, that's fine. Alright, altitude is gonna be auto, I guess. Oh wait, no, we're going to Phoenix. That's right, Phoenix. Sorry, not say SFO. Going to Phoenix. All right. So that's good. Okay, so we got our fuel and everything. Alright, so we're gonna go on that. Okay, let's go back to our documentary. Okay, so pressurization, we're going to set it to our altitude, our cruising altitude, which is going to be 330. That's already set for us. The landing altitude at Phoenix, let me get that real quick. I don't know where we're landing. I think we're going to... we'll just land to the east. Actually, you know what? Nah. We're gonna actually do this. So let's go ahead and pull up the wind here. Go to Phoenix. And, okay, the winds are in favor of the 8 for the eastbound, so we'll land for runway 7 right. So 7 right is going to be at an elevation of 111 or 1111. And we got a new follower, Johansson 2005. Thank you for the follow, very much appreciated. Thank you, thank you. We're just going to round it to 1110. So we got the wind and everything. Let's see if what else we got on the checklist. Alright, so we got pressurization set and good to go. Mode selector is going to be set to auto, so let's see, mode selector. Alright, mode selector is already set to auto for us, so that's good. Flight ground switch is going to be set to ground. Where is that at? Flight ground switch. There it is right there. So there it is. We got that set to ground, so that's good. air conditioning if required. We'll go ahead and turn that on. If I can find the view, there we go. We'll go ahead and turn them on, I guess. Yeah, let's go and turn them on. Operate the AP for at least 1 minute before switching the first AC pack switch to on. Okay, so we're good. APU EGT in green band. No, it's not in a green, in the green band. It's going way past the green band. Yeah, not doing so good. I'm gonna turn the packs off for now. I don't know why it's in the red. Alright, air temperature indicator. Don't worry about that. Air temp selector. Air temp selector. Where does that look? Main supply. Yep, main supply is good. Air mix valve position indicators. Full coal, which I think is those right there. Just have those on auto. So. Cabin temperature controls are set to auto. Duct overheat lights are checked. Yeah, those are good. Engine bleed valve, engine bleed air switches four, all four are going to be set to open. So we got 1, 2, 3, and 4, so those are good to go. Auto pack trip arm light, auto pack trip arm light is good. Pack trip lights are off, pack trip off lights check, duct pressure. Yeah, so those are good. Duct pressure, normal source, left and right pack, cooling doors, position indicators full open, cargo heat, outflow switch, cargo heat, outflow switch is set to normal, left and right pack temperature indicators, where are those located at? What was the left and right pack cooling door position? Just roll open cargo heat flow. Left and right pack temperature indicators. Ambient? I don't know what. I don't know how to tell if they're. I don't know. APU ammeter within limits of activating pack. If APU is power source observed, maximum 120. If external power is source above 150. Oh wait, can we turn these off? What the? I don't know, whatever. Where were we at? APU ammeter, within limits for activating pack. APU is power source observed maximum 120. There's no power is power source observed maximum 5. Gasper fan switches as desired, cabin air distribution selector as required. First aid lights are checked, emergency exit light switch is on. Emergency exit light switch, okay, it's like a test. Passenger signs, we're not gonna worry about passenger signs because they're not carrying passengers. Window heat is, Window heat is checked. Window heat switches are... Is it supposed to be four? Oh, okay, these two, okay. Alright, so those are good to go. Observe all power lights illuminated. If not, all lights are illuminated. Okay, test switch. Not worried about that. Window heat switches off / reset. Okay. Wing and engine anti-ice systems, duct overheat, duct temperature corrected. Okay. Alright, so valve position, light selector. Valve position, light selector. Should be right down here. Here we go. The valve position, light selector. Wing anti-ice switches, valve. Yes. Preliminary. A long checklist. Oh my god. Alright, prior to before start checklist. Airplane loading. We're gonna get the airplane loaded. God, there's a lot to the preliminary checklist. That is a ton of stuff. Okay, Okay, so total fuel, we need, $21,936. So, let's round it to 22,000 pounds. So that will be good. And then our cargo weight, going to be 1,200. Where's cargo? Cargo hold weight? Main cargo weight. How do we change the cargo? Okay, this is main cargo. Oh shoot, that's fuel. God dang it. Alright, hold on. Let's round out to 22,000. Alright. Yeah, I can't change the cargo. Well, I mean, I guess I could here. Let's do random. Do random. Okay, that should be fine. We're gonna go and go with that. So we're all loaded up for the fuel and all and the loading. So we're good. Gross weight is checked. Center of gravity is checked. Fuel system. We're gonna set that for start. Still can do those, but... fuel system, boost pump switches, one on each main tank. So just one? Okay. Crossfeed selector, number two open, number, so let's see, crossfeed selectors. Number two open, number one and three close. So those are good. Number three is open. Number one, two are closed. So that's good. Crossbeat selector. Number two, main tank fuel greater than main tanks one or three. No. So it's not greater. Wait, number two is this one, right? Yeah, engine number two. Okay, so it's not greater. That's good. Yeah, okay. So we're good. Hydraulic pressure and quantities are normal. Ground interconnect switch is closed. Hydraulic A pressure. Hydraulic A pressure. Where is it? Hydraulic A pressure decreases. Yeah, okay, I guess. And then system B pump switch. One is off, one comes on. Pump number one or two may be turned off. Observe system B brake pressure. Okay, so that's good. Normal elevation field different. What? Oil. Okay, so I guess we're fine. I don't know. System A flight controls low pressure. Okay, well. All right, enunciators illuminated. If flaps are up, rudder load limiter light illuminated. I have no idea. Rudder load light. What is? Oh, is it down here? Okay, red. Okay, there we go. Illuminated. No, it's not illuminated. It flaps are up, though. Oh, boy. Pressurization barometric indicator. I'll set that later. Takeoff data card. Windows are checked. Make sure windows open. Okay. Anti-skid switches will be checked and on. Just gotta find out where it's at. Anti-skid, here we go. I'm assuming that they're on. Anti-skid switches, and we got a follow. Aiden 13547, welcome to the stream. Thank you for the follow, very much appreciated. You're going to be in for a very slow and painful stream to watch. If you've flown this plane before, know from the back of your head, I have no idea how to fly this plane or operate this plane, so we're going to be here on the ground for a little while. Airplane loading. Oh, I already did that. Whoops. Alright, anti-skid switches are checked and on. Anti-skid system is checked and on. Yeah, so we're good there. Make sure airplane is chocked, yeah. Park brakes, release? Uh, I'm gonna put my park brake back on. Alright, so park brake is good to go. Main gearing is good, not gonna worry about that. Test switch, not gonna worry about that. Start working, check, not gonna worry about that. Emergency exit lights are on. Panel lights are check, exterior lights are... we have our... We're gonna get our nav lights on, we're gonna get our beacon lights on. So those are good to go. Instrument panels, secured, I guess. Pneumatic brake lever off and safe tie. Pneumatic brake. What's that? That's right here, right? Yep, pneumatic brake is set. APD lights. I have no idea what the APD lights are. I don't know. Flight instruments are checked. Yeah, damper switches should be on, which I think they're up here. Where's the yaw damper? Maybe it's at the bottom, I don't know. Geez, where is the yaw damper? I think the yaw damper is up top somewhere. Yaw damper, where is it? Or is it down here? Oh, right there. So yaw damper, what do we have to set that to? Yaw damper switch it on? Yaw damper, I have no idea where the yaw dampers are then. Oh, here they are. Okay, so those are on. Okay, there's the yaw damper. Okay, so those are good. Let's see, yaw damper, where was that? Yaw damper switches are good. Upper and lower yaw damper or rudder, YD flags retracted, test switch. I think those are good. Alright, let's go to the next page. Test switch, passenger signs, not gonna worry about the window heats are coming on. Window heats are on. Total air temperature indicator. Where's that at? I have no idea where it's at, but whatever. Altitude alert. I guess, I don't know. Altitude. Standby horizon check, flight position indicators are... I don't know where they're at, but we're gonna say it's check. Engine, low oil pressure lights are check, radios, instruments, all stuff. Good autopilot, confirm disengage. Altitude hole, I think it's down here. It is disengaged, so that's good. Mode selector, as did I want mode selector? I don't know. Altitude hold switch is off. Pitch command control. Climb altitude. I don't know, course selectors as desired, heading selector, set runway heading, departure VHF frequency set, transponder, radar, engine control not set for start, reverse thrust levers full down, thrust lever, start levers cut. Oh, okay, I think that's right. Alright, park brake is set, stabilizer trim checked and set for takeoff, rudder trim free and zero, stabilizer brakes release, disengage, documents on board, V2. We have to set the D speed bugs. Okay, so those are set. Pick up information. Galley power switches. I think it's over. Oh, wrong view. Galley power switches are off. Can I set these off now? No, I cannot. Galley power switches, where was I at? Oh, here we go. Pack switches are coming off, or they're already off. Amplified before start checklist. When all appropriate pre-flight protections are complete, the captain will call for a before start checklist. The officer will read out each other's challenge and receive their appropriate response. Captain preparation, any skaters armed, stall warning is checked, emergency exit lights are on, passenger signs are on, window heats are on, any ice is closed. Flight permits and directors set and cross-checked. Compasses are synced and checked, radios. Start levers are cut off. Wait. Yeah, they're cut off. Park brakes are set, rudder and aileron trims, free and zero, fuel, set for start, hydraulics, inner close, press and quantity normal. Just make sure that the hydraulics are good. Hydraulics, inner close, okay, so check ground interconnect, closing all pressures and quantities normal, papers on board. After clearance for engine emergency, the captain will position the beacon, switch to on, and the flight engineer will position the galley power switch, and both pack switches to off, and verify the max deck pressure within the engine's 20 PSI. When directed, the first officer will continue reading checklist. Beacon is on, galley power is off, packs are off, start pressure is 20 plus PSI. Before start checklist complete. To successfully start the engine, the following procedure should be used. Normal starting procedures to start engine 3, followed by 2 and 1. To begin start, ensure all bleeding air switches are open. Okay, those are good. One bleed air pressure is above 20 PSI, you can continue with the procedure. The bleed air PSI is above 20, so that's good. On the overhead panel, open the guard over the ignition switch. Click the switch once to commence engine start. Oh, wait, hold on. Where's the ignition? Fantastic, good. Is this the ignition? No, that's the emergency exit lights. What am I talking about? Engine starts. Here we go. Okay, let's go ahead and get our better pushback ready here.
Ground to cockpit. Plan acknowledged. Call me through the menu when you are ready.
Okay, now I have to align the gate, or my, up here, so fun. We are at the which one are we on? Let me see. We're on number 8. So the coordinates for 8. I need to figure out how to enter. So north. Okay, now we have to insert. So north is 3356. Zero. Okay. And then west is 118229. Insert. And then we go to align if I'm correct. So I do have the SIVA user guide, so let me go and check this out. Make sure. Okay. Navigation and explain flight plan. These way you see the. Going load up to 9 waypoints from an explain flight plan to load a regular. Make sure to power up the AC power and the avionics busted aircraft you're flying. The SIVA can also operate up to 30 minutes before its internal battery, which can get you down in case of emergency with lots of AC power. Start by turning the data selector to the standby position. Observe the. Check out the mode is 0, not nav. No malfunction is displayed. Performance index is 9. The worst and desired performance is 5. Next. Rotate the data selector to pause. Now you have to initialize the position to currently ramp your aircraft. You get the coordinates from your airport chart, so you can look them up. On so it's like, and I was like, oh, you can also use X-Wing data. To convert the decimal degrees to enter position into DDU, you have to do the following. Start with selecting the hemisphere by pressing 2 north and that. Observe an insert button light up. Now into the 5-digit sequence of latitude degrees, minutes, and tenths of a minute. If you make a mistake when entering, press clear. If you enter the latitude correct, then press insert button. Next, the select hemisphere of the longitude by pressing either 4 west or observe the insert button. Okay. Sequence longitude. Okay. Minutes and tenths of a minute. Press insert button to confirm the entry. Please note that longitude is always 6 digits instead of 5 because longitudes go from. A lot of trees only go ahead. Okay. Now make sure the parking brake is set and the plane is not moving. Set the data selector back to DSRTK slash SCS and rotate the mode selector to align. Okay. Note that alignment will start after the warm up phase is complete. Warm up time is dependent on the current outside air temperature. The colder it is, the longer it'll take for the unit to warm up. At 15 degrees Celsius outside air temperature, warm will take a little more than 5 minutes. Note that warm starts as soon as you select the standby. As you select standby mode. So while you leave, or while you have been fiddling with the initial position, then it will. The unit will probably already be warm. You can now watch the system go through its alignment. During alignment, the performance index will count down. The initial 920. Total time it takes to complete this countdown depends on your latitude. The nearer you are to the equator, the faster alignment will be. At 40 degrees of latitude, alignment will take slightly less than 10 minutes. During the waiting time, you may proceed with the normal flight plane entry. See next section. You may also choose to cheat and skip along the long waiting period by clicking the hidden spot on the ready nav light. Note that the performance index 8. A test of internal batteries commence, which you can see by yellow bat light on the CDU lighting up. If also the red bat light on the MSU lights up, the internal battery is critically low and it is unsafe to rely on it. As soon as the performance index is less or equal to the desired performance index, the green ready nav button, or light, the MSU will light up. Okay. It indicates alignment is now sufficient for flight operation. You can still enhance navigation performance by further letting the aircraft sit with the parking brake set and the most selected in align, while the performance index and index counts further down. Until finally to zero. But at any time the ready nav light button is lit up, you can commence navo by rotating the mode selector to nav. Note the ready nav light extinguishes and the status light display now reads. Okay, so I'm gonna hit. Okay, so. So that there's a hidden button. Speed up the process. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Because I'm not gonna sit here and wait for this number to go down to zero. Hidden spot. Click the hidden spot on the ready nav light button. Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. That's good to go. Now we're at 5. Okay, so that's good to go. So now we're aligned and ready. The light is lit up. Alright, so, as soon as the performance index is less than equal to the desired performance, ready now, it indicates alignment, further down, until finally to zero. But at any time ready nav light is lit up, you can commence nav mode by rotating the mode selector to nav. We're gonna set it to nav. Note the ready nav light extinguishes and the status display now reads status code action malfunction accurate index and then desired AP index, so we're good. The mode index shows 1 for nav mode. The performance index has now been replaced by the accuracy index. It will slowly increase during flight, indicating navigation accuracy fades due to long operation without position updating. Note that the accuracy index does not correspond to a specific navigation performance radius and is not suitable for RNP operation. The desired AP index will always display 4 in this simulation. A triple mixing or update eradication are not suitable. You may use the flight plan loading feature as described as easy mode, or you may choose to enter waypoints manually. The entry procedure is as follows. Start the data selected waypoint, turn the waypoint selector thumb wheel to the one slot, and you can enter the first waypoint like you did for the initial position. Oh my god, okay. The entry procedure, turn the data selector. Okay, so turn the data selector to waypoint. Okay. Oh, I see it. I see. Now you can enter the first waypoint like you did for the initial position. First select altitude hemisphere. Okay, hold on. Thumb wheel. Oh, here we go. Okay, this. Okay. Okay, that's okay, that's good. Turn the waypoint selector thumb wheel to the one slot. Now you can enter the first waypoint. Okay, so now I gotta look at my charts. Aircraft charts. So we gotta go to the stars, and we're gonna be on the, what was it? Dots 2 departure. Dots 2. How do we get the coordinates for the waypoints, though? Oh, wait. Simbrief. Use your Simbrief. I need to open this in Skyvector. Here we go. So we're gonna go to Docker. Oh, here we go. All right, so Docker is going to be North 335591. The North 335591. Oh shit. Insert. Okay. And then Wes is going to be 118.27.49.4. 118.27.4. Okay. Insert. Then our next waypoint is going to be Wheeler or Weiler. 335546. And then Wes is going to be 118.294. Okay, this is gonna take a while, so I'm not gonna enter in all of the waypoints. But from Wheeler, we could probably go straight to PV. So we'll go straight to PV, which is gonna be 334183. So P3 Then we'll go west. 118312. Then from PV, from PV we can go straight to we can go to Holtz. So 33386. Then for the west we go 11820. Wait, 118205. And then we'll go to dots, I guess. Then we'll go to dots. Which is going to be 3338. So 33386. And then west going to be 117478. 7. Okay, then we'll go to the next one. And after dot, we'll go... After dots, we're gonna go, we're gonna skip a few other points, we're gonna go to, Skull. So, let's go to Skull, it's gonna be 33277. It's gonna be 114049. 114049. And then after Skull, we'll go straight to Swoon. The Swoon will be 33178. So we're good there. And West, we're going to 11304. 048. Wait, what did I just read? 113. Yeah, I messed that one up. 113138. Okay, we can only enter 8 or 9. So I need to use these last few as best I can. And then after Spoon, go Hydra. I'll go Hydra. So, 33164. Then we'll go West. 13304. Okay. 11304. 1. Alright, then the last waypoint is gonna be Phoenix. Perfect. So, Phoenix is going to be 3326. And West, 112006. Oh, 006. 12006. Okay. Insert. Okay. We're done. Alright. We got all of our waypoints set in. Or at least not all of them, but the ones that we need. The ones that will help us get there. The mode index shows. Okay. We got that. So. The enter the latitude. Or longitude hemisphere. Enter the longitude. I'll verify the coordinates. Up to 9 waypoints that can be stored in the unit. Note that you can enter the waypoints while in standby, line, or nav mode, which means you can program your flight plan while alignment is still in progress. Display modes. Left display shows ground track related to true north and first tenth of a degree. Right shows ground speeds and knots. HDG heading /DA, whatever that's in. Good. Left display shows heading related to true north nearest tenth of a degree. Note that this heading will be different from the heading shown on the right display or on the HSI because HSI shows track related to magnetic north. Right display shows drift angle due to wind from 0 to 180 degrees, suffixed L for left or R for right. Left display shows latitude of current airplane position degrees, minutes, lengths, tenths of a minute. Right display shows longitude, current airplane position degrees, minutes, tenths of a minute. Waypoint shows latitude. Waypoint shows latitude in left and longitude right. The current waypoint is chosen and indicated within the waypoint selector thumb wheel. Left display shows distance. Left display shows distance in tenths of a nautical mile to current active takeoff waypoint or active two waypoint. Right display shows time in tenths of minutes to currently active two waypoint based on current ground speed. Wind, that's pretty self-explanatory. Alright, DRTSKSTS. Left display shows desired track angle to current takeoff waypoint or. I don't know. Takeoff waypoint in degrees. Right display shows status codes as described in the warm up and alignment section hold mode. The hold mode. To enter hold mode, press the hold key and observe it until it's lit up. Oh, okay, I see. Display modes are following. Let's. Okay. To intercept a leg from one waypoint to another, press waypoint change. Waypoint change? Where's that at? Oh, waypoint change, there we go. Intercept a leg from one waypoint to another, press waypoint change, then the number of the waypoint on the from end of the leg. On the from end of the leg, then enter the number of the waypoint on the to end of the leg. For example, if you're currently headed to waypoint 1, instead, I want to intercept the leg from waypoint 3 to waypoint 4. Press waypoint change 3-4. Note that it is not possible to construct a leg that goes on the opposite waypoint order of your flight plan. Direct next waypoint. To go directly from your present position to waypoint in your flight plan, press waypoint change, then 0. Okay, then 0. And then the number of the waypoint you want to go direct to. For example, if you're currently headed to waypoint 1 instead want to go direct to waypoint 4, press waypoint change 0, then 4. Okay, I get it. DME update. DME station will be used to improve the accuracy of inertial navigation and get rid of the accumulated position error. For optimum performance, you should select the DME between 59 miles and 209 miles, or 209 miles off track to either side of your flight path. Start with looking up some suitable DME on the map. Note its frequency, position, and station elevation. If you don't have a real route navigational chart, information to obtain from what that's like. Turn the data selector to waypoint before beginning DME updating. Disconnect autopilot from the INS by going into heading or roll mode. Use the waypoint selector to select a slot between 1 and 9. 0 is unavailable for DME update. Now press the keys 7 and 9 simultaneously. You can do that with the mouse. You have to activate keyboard input and do the following. Hold down the Alt key. Now press first 7, then 9. After that, release the Alt key. You are now in DME entry mode. Wow. Note that displays will have reverted from displaying waypoint coordinates to DME, so you are not going to overwrite a waypoint by entering the T-port. Use the normal entry procedure to enter the select altitude hemisphere, enter latitude, press insert, select longitude hemisphere, enter longitude, press insert. Oh god, that's a lot. I'm about to do that next time. Oh boy. Okay, well, we're all set up. I know that was a lot. Trust me. So now we get to continue with the checks. Finally, that was a lot to go through. We literally spent an hour and 60 minutes on the ground trying to figure this plane out. On the overhead panel, the guard over there is trying to click in. Okay, so let's go and get the pushback going. Let's go and get the pushback started. Let's go to better pushback and start pushback.
Ground to cockpit. Tow is driving up.
Oh, I didn't want to do that.
Okay, all doors and hatches are closed. Ready to connect.
Okay. So let's hope I didn't miss anything, because I have no idea what I'm doing with this plane, to be honest with you guys. I'm still learning. This is like my first time getting this far, so I have no idea.
Tow connected and bypassed and inserted. Release parking brake. Starting pushback, and you may start engines.
Okay. Go and try to start our first engine. Cool, I think we got our first engine started. Well, that sounds like a good engine to me. Oh yeah.
Operation complete. Set parking brake. Disconnecting tow. Stand by.
Yeah, I think that's a good second engine.
Tow is disconnected, and bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal on the left. We'll see you next time, and have a safe flight.
Oh no. I didn't mean to press the... Okay, now what? After start procedure, after engine have been started and have stabilized, the following tasks are performed to configure the airplane to taxi. Electrical power transfer. Let's find out how we do that. Electrical power. Transfer how? Electrical power. Where's the power? I don't see, I have no idea. Electrical power transfer? Where's that located? FAP power source. AC meter selector, gen 1, 2, and 3. Verify bulletin frequency normal for each generator. Good. Number one generator breaker. There we go. Essential power selector. Rotate the power selector. Essential power selector? Yeah. Gen 1, 2, and 3. Rotate. Power go out up there? I thought that's turning on and off. Uh-oh, that's not good. Alright, observe number one generator breaker light, extinguish the AP generator breaker light, illuminate. Okay, so they're extinguished. Leave in Gen 3. If external power is power source, now we don't know. How to start pursuing number two generator breaker. Close. Essential power selector. Rotate the. Okay. Number three generator breaker. Good. AC meter selector. Gen three. Essential power selector. Gen three. Ready for disconnect announced. Galley power switches are coming on. Fuel system. Set for takeoff, I guess. Don't turn those on. set for takeoff. All remaining main fuel tank pumps. Okay, good. We do. All low pressure lights are. No, they're not extinguished. Oh. There we go. I forgot those two pumps as well. There we go. Alright, all low pressure lights are extinguished. Hydraulic system A is checked, I guess. Yeah, there we go. Hydraulic system A is checked. That's good. Hydraulic system A pump 1 switch will come on. So I think it's already in the on position. It looks like it's on. check that system pressure, or system A pressure indicates 2800 to 3100 on the PSI. That's good. It's in the green. At idle thrust, so yeah, thrust is idle. Hydraulic A pump 2 switch is off. Hydraulic A. Hold on. Check that system A pressure decreases. Didn't decrease at all. Oh wait. Okay, there it goes. Yeah, I had to turn both of them off. Whoops. All right, there we go. Now it comes back up. Hydraulic system A pump, number 2 switch is on. Alright, ground equipment is disconnected, doors are checked, taxi clearance obtained, ground equipment is clear. After start checklist. That's supposed to be on. I guess not, it doesn't tell me, so I'm so. I'm gonna turn it on actually. I don't trust it, so I'm gonna turn it on. Go and check this. Okay, can the APU come off? There. Our APU's off. Alright, fire taxi, ground equipment is cleared, fuel set for takeoff, doors are checked, F-start checklist is complete. Taxi out procedure, parking brake is going to be released, taxi will begin. We're going to set our flaps for takeoff. What did we set in the, here? So flaps are going to be 20 degrees, wait, 20 degrees for takeoff? That's a little much. But we'll do it anyways. That's what our paper says. Alright, there we go. Flaps are set. Oh yeah, trim. Stabilized trim is going to be 7.29. Seven. There we go. We are good to go. Let's go. Flap lever is set for takeoff. Exterior lighting. Let's go and get our taxi light on. And park brake is released. Let's go ahead and power on forward. We are finally getting out of here. After an hour and a half of trying to get this plane familiarized, pretty much. Oh god, that was a deadly stop. Alright. Oh yeah, we gotta get our packs on. Okay, let's see, what else we got? So, pitot static heat switches. Where are those located at? Got the probe heaters, and those are the pitot heats, so we're good there. Nav instruments, we're going to get the nav instruments, those are checked. Speed brake / flap warning, checked, well not simulated. Flight control warning, speed brake lever. Is there a way to arm this speed brake? I don't know. IOMC Gator, thank you for the follow. Very much appreciated. Thank you, thank you. I don't know how you arm this. That's alright, we'll figure it out on the checklist. Amortizers are checked. Speed brake lever is detent. Flight control warning test, stabilizer trim set for takeoff flight controls. They are free and correct. Engine operation good, fuel heat as required, we don't need fuel heat. Fuel heat switches, we don't need them. Fuel heat switches off, hydraulics. Oh, this is takeout, taxi out, or no, Okay, it's KFC. I read that wrong. Hydraulic system set for flight. Other hydraulic system B pump switches on. Pressure and quantities are normal. Elevation, fuel, different press and rudder load limiter lights are extinguished. Yes. No equipment cooling light is extinguished. Double check back here. Yeah, we're good back here. Pneumatic system set for flight. I don't know where the pneumatic system is, but we should be fine. Should be fine. Should be. Engine 2 APU bleed air switches are closed. Left AC pack switch is on, right AC pack switch is on, pressurization system is set for flight. Flight ground switch will now be set to flight. So there we go. Observe outflow valve moving. It is moving. So is the valve, so that's good. Let's go to the next page. AP master switch is off. Prepare for takeoff announcement is complete. Takeoff briefing. Landing lights will be going line up on the runway. It doesn't arm, just so you know. The neutral position is all there is, as far as I know. For what? Sorry, I was going through the checklist and I read so much I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know what you're referencing to.
Approaching 2-5 left.
Alright, let's hope we didn't mess anything up. Because this is my first time literally flying this plane. Like, I just bought this plane yesterday, and I haven't touched it, really, until now. Until this stream. So, wish me luck that I got everything right.
On runway, 2-5 left.
Alright, let me just do the checks here. So flaps are green and set for takeoff. Okay, so landing lights are on transponder. I didn't set my transponder, but we're not on VAT sim or anything, so it doesn't really matter. CSD oil cooler. Auto pack trip system. Where is that located? I think it's over here. Auto pack trip system. Auto pack trip system normal. Oh, here we go. Normal. Okay, there we go. Alright, so we're good. We got that. CSD oil cooler. Let me just make sure that is off, because it says it's supposed to be off. So let me just find it real quick and make sure it's off.
On runway 2-5 left. On runway 2-5 left.
CSD oil cooler. Where? Right. It should be around here, maybe. Cooling doors. I mean, I guess it's. I'm gonna say it's off. I'm not seeing anything about it, so. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say it's off. Heater heats are on, flight instruments, flight director. Are there flight directors? Flight director, yeah, there is. Okay. Alright, flight controls are checked, speed brake is extended, stabilizer trim are set, flaps are set, galley power is on, electrical, no lights. Oh, ESS3, let's make sure we set that to ESS3. Electrical, no lights, ESS, oh wait, verify all lights on electrical panel are extinguished and the essential power selector is set to Gen 3, okay, good, we got that. Unplug before takeoff checklist, fuel heat is off, hydraulics pressure and quantity is normal, elevator rubber APU, enunciator light is off, flight, sounds ground switch, set the flight air conditioning and press, no, two bleeds closed instead, so it's good. EPR and airspeed bugs are set, takeoff briefing is completed, clear for takeoff, start switches are, guarded.
On runway 2, 5 left.
Alright, let's get out of here before they start doing some more stuff. Alright, reduce the brake. Gonna add some power. Engines look stable. We're gonna release the brake. Let's hope for the best, guys. I have no idea how to fly this plane, so... We're learning. Okay, I'm gonna have to pause real quick, guys. I don't like pausing mid-sim, but this is the brand new plane. This is my first time taking this thing off. I'm gonna pause real quick. I'm gonna go over the after takeoff checklist. The things that are important. So, careful of that. I need to know is autopilot. If desired, engage. So, what we are doing is, I think it's nav. Localizer. Oh, yeah, and then we need to hit engage down here. Now, my hopes is that this will work. This will come up. That's what I want to. So let's go ahead and unpause, engage autopilot, see what happens. Flaps up zero. Too fast. Okay, so it doesn't seem like our following are. Is it not? Okay, so we're obviously going further and further away from it. Why is it not tracking? Tracking. Oh boy. Okay, with autopilot engaged, position heading select. Heading selector. Select desired heading rotate mode. Selector, nav, look, curve 8, autopilot, approach and progress display. Observe the plane turn to the selected heading and for the airport, view our local flight and limit radio is captured. Observe airplane track the except for navigation mode selector. Heading to L. That look. Right there. Nav selector. Here we go. Just gonna do auto manual. Try that. Oh, I think I got it. I think that did it. Yeah, look at that. We are getting close. Alright, cool. We got it figured out. Perfect. Where's my vertical speed? I don't Alright, well, that plane's doing good, so I did something right. Turn the sounds down though, it's super loud. It is extremely loud. Get some music going. I'm just reading over some stuff about this plane so I know how to fly it. Become more familiarized with the aircraft.
Altimeter setting.
see. We're on the Hydra 1 arrival. The Phoenix. What the hell? What the hell is the plane doing? What the hell? I It's 3 a.m. and I'm yet to be tired, probably because I'm too busy handing out my number to people. That might be it. I've been getting memes and dick pics. Wow. That's, okay. How the hell do you get this plane to... How do you get this plane to hold 30, like, your altitude? Doing it now? Two streamers actually texting me out there. Streams, nice. Don't know what, but it is probably bad. Well, I wouldn't do it, but. Sebastian2803, thank you for the follow. Very much appreciated. Thank you, thank you. Okay, so the only problem with this bike is I don't know when to descend. I don't have... I don't have ATC. And there's no VOR charts for the rival. There's nothing VOR related. Maybe I should start flying with an FMC. I have no idea how to fly this at all. I mean, it'll take some learning, but... check charts. So we're gonna be at Skull. Hold that. Skull's not even on here. On my charts. Because we're going direct to Swoon. How would you even fly this arrival? Yeah, next time I fly this plane, I'm just flying with an FMC. have to start descending for Swoon here. Swoon is going to be an altitude of... we'll do it at 15,000. Hey, Danny, what's up? Welcome back. How are we getting further away? What? There we go. Okay, are we still going further away? What the f- What? I see what it is. I see. Yeah, we're still good on fuel. Thank you. where the hell the plane is bringing me, but bringing me somewhere. Oh my god. Whoa. Whoa, what the hell? Um Massive turbulence? Oh my god! Why is the turbulence so bad here? That's not good. This is not good. What in the world? What was that all about? Wow. Oh, geez, that was deadly. Hopefully we can see the airport. There it is. Yeah, this plane with the SIVA navigation, no joke. I'm making a jank approach, but I just want to get this plane down. What's going on? What is this? Instant zero, like, instant low visibility. Can't see a damn thing.
Approaching 07 left.
There's our runway on the right. You know, we're just gonna go on the left runway, screw it. My God, maintaining speed in this is so weird. Oh, I'm way off. I am way off.
Long landing, 8,000 feet remaining.
Oh my god, that was... It's the stupid weather. What's wrong with the weather here? Okay, well, it's good to know that the speed brakes automatically deploy for you, so that's good. Oh my god, that was actually a pretty stressful approach. Arrival and approach. Okay, I'm gonna park over where the military planes are because I really don't care. Actually, I'm not even gonna park. We're gonna watch a replay back, and we're gonna watch how terrible that approach was. Alright, we're gonna watch back that terrible landing. Okay. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't good either. The approach was trash. The arrival was trash on my part. Being new to the whole SIVA navigational system, it's so weird. Yeah, all right. All right, guys, that's going to be the end of the stream. I am going to call it there. I have a lot to learn about this little guy down here because it's so confusing. I don't know if he used the... It's just so confusing. If we fly this plane on Bat-Sim, we're using the FMC. We're not using this. If I use this, I'm flying offline, or not on Bat-Sim. It's so confusing. It's so confusing. I mean, it's not really confusing. Like, I know how to use it, but, like, when you're on your approach, there's no VORs to come into these airports. I mean, there's no, like, parts for the VORs and stuff, but for VOR approaches... But other than that, hope you guys enjoyed. It was just a stressful approach. Like, plane is just, the autopilot system is weird, weird to me. It's very strange, it's gonna take some time getting used to. But we'll do another flight and we'll do it with the FMC next time. So that way it's a little faster and we get to focus more on the systems because I know how to use FMCs, so you won't have to worry about using the SIVA system or me trying to figure out how to use it. Even though it's pretty basic to use. We'll do that next time. Another time. But on that, guys, hope you guys enjoyed, and as always, I will see you guys in the next one. Have a great night, guys.